Dear friends in Christ, to all of you, a very happy and blessed New Year and a grace-filled feast of Mary, Mother of God. Today we honor Mary as the Mother of God. But how can a human person become the mother of her own Creator, who is uncreated and eternal? Today's Gospel reading shows Mary is the mother of Jesus. And Jesus is both God and man. He is a divine person, God the Son, who took human nature. Jesus, therefore, is one person with two natures, divine and human. A mother conceives and gives birth to a person, not to a nature. Since Mary's Son is a divine person, she is the mother of God. That title is applicable to her only on account of Jesus, her Son, who is Emmanuel, God with us. It was the Council of Ephesus that in the year 431 defined Mary as the Mother of God, because from her was generated the sacred body of the Word incarnate. Mary's virginity was made fruitful by the power of the Holy Spirit. Therefore, her child is of divine origin. Saint Elizabeth called her the Mother of my Lord. Being children of God, as the second reading tells us, we are also brothers of Jesus, and his mother is our mother too. From the cross, Jesus said, "She is your mother." So today we are celebrating the Mother of God and our mother. As children learn their first and most precious lessons from their mothers, let us also learn our spiritual lessons from Mother Mary. Her prayerfulness, humility, surrender to God's will, obedience, love for Christ, love for neighbor, gratitude to God, and trust in Jesus are shining examples for us to imitate. Let us draw comfort and strength from the presence and protection of Mary and follow her footsteps on the path to holiness. We have just stepped into 2020. This moment can bring us an element of sorrow for our failures of the past year. But for all of us, it is an element of joy, as it is a moment of hope that opens new possibilities and opportunities. It is therefore a moment of resolve. It is worth asking ourselves what last year meant for us. What have we gained and what have we learned from it? And what do I expect from 2020 as its days, weeks and months pass? None of us is certain about what this year will bring us. But one thing we know, how I venture into the new year depends on me. We learn from the past, grasp the present and venture into the future. I learn from my mistakes and entrust them to God's mercy. I venture into the new year with gratitude, trust, goodwill and purpose. I must become a little better every day, a bit more human, a bit more understanding and a bit more caring. Such things come from my heart and they are what count. I must take responsibility for my words and deeds and resist the temptation to blame others. Our life is made up of multiple relationships. Relationship with our Creator, with ourselves, with our fellow humans, and with our world. The right relationships will bring us peace, harmony, and joy. By loving, we become lovable. Love begets love. That way, this year will be for us a time of grace and growth. May it be so for all of us. Through Mother Mary's intercession, may the Lord bless you and keep you, be gracious to you, and give you peace all through this new year.
For further updates, subscribe to our channel and please click on the bell icon. Thanks for watching.